good day to all my fellow travelers, friends, and photographers around the world. Welcome to Chris Lee Travel Channel. Time flies. Ever since I take a break for the Lunar New Year, 3 weeks have passed, and today I shall bring you to a nation which I have introduced before in my first series with compressor, 6 episodes. And today I shall commence my second series, another 6 episodes of my travel journey to this great nation, Iran. For those who have missed my first series of my journey to Iran, I strongly recommend you go to my channel and go through all of them. So, in today, I'm going to share with you a very beautiful and very famous square in the city of Isfahan. And within this square, there are located quite a number of historical and fascinating buildings, which I will share with you one by one. Firstly is this Ali Qapu Palace, and then will be this mosque, the Isfahan mosque in so-called Lotfolloh mosque. And lastly is another mosque, is called the Shah mosque, or also known as Iman Mosque, after 1979. So Iran, as shown in this map, is a Middle East country, and you can look at the size of this Iran. It's just a big nation. And Iran have actually quite a number of provinces, and for our journey, we only cover 4 provinces. But today, I will be only covering the provinces nearing to this north section, as the first series of my travelogue have covered the lower sections. So now, let's look at this city of Isfahan. Now, city of Isfahan, if you look carefully, we are actually at more toward the center north sections of the Iran. Now, it is actually a provincial capital of Isfahan province, and is the third most populous city of Iran, and is located about 406 kilometers south of Tehran, which is around 2 million population, which was recorded in the year 2018. Now, it's geographically important as it's located at the intersection of 2 principal so-called north-south and east-west trunk road of Iran. If you look at this map, you can see that there is very few cities in Iran that serve this both the north-south and east-west trunk road, and Isfahan is one of them. So the location of Isfahan in relation to Tehran, the capital city of Iran, is as shown in this map. And this is the trip notes routes taken by me in the year 2017. And Isfahan is the second last stop of our travels. And we have covered from A all the way to the east sections in my series 1, and now we are covering from F and H and I in this series 2. So first, let's have a look of this Isfahan, get further knowledge about this city. Now, city Isfahan was founded in the year 1050. In other words, it's close to 1,000 years ago, then flourished till 1722, when it was right under the Safavid Empire. Now, when it was the capital of Persia for the second time in history. So in other words, Isfahan was once the capital city. Now, Isfahan is popular for its Perso-Islamic architectures, the grand boulevards, covered bridges, palaces, town mosques, and minarets. It's a city that with modern building, with many historical landmarks from the past. So today, we're going to bring you to all these historical landmarks, although not all, but the major one. So let's look at this layout plan of this Naghsh-e Jahan Square. Now, this is a long square. Let's touch a bit on some background. Now, this Naghsh-e Jahan Square is one of the largest city square in the world, as well as in Iran. Now, this square, located at the center of Isfahan city, was constructed between 1598 till 1629. Naghsh-e Jahan, right, in Persian language, translates into the image of the world square. Now, it's commonly known as the Iman Square or Shah Square. Now, the Shah Square was used before 1979. After 1979, they have been changed to Iman Square. Now, the square measures 160 meters by 500 meters, as can be seen in this layout map, and cover an area of approximately 89,600 square meters. Now, entire square is surrounded by iconic buildings built during the Safavid era. At the south is Shah Mosque, as can be seen in the maps, and on the west is the Ali Qapu Palace. At the northern end is where the quarry gates will leading you to the bazaar area. And of course, another mosque, the Sheikh Lotfolloh Mosque, is then on the eastern side of the square. So in other words, at the four corners of the square, they all situated, located the iconic building, historical building. Now, the Friday prayer is held in the Shan or Iman Mosque at every Fridays. Now, the square is an important, right, historical site and awarded the UNESCO World Cultural Heritage site in the year 1979. So let's begin our tour of the square with all this iconic building. So this is overview, the overview of the square that we took from the Qapu Palace. Of course, in the center of the square, they located a large fountain pool. And a visit to Isfahan, the stopover in this square, is a must, as it's also one of the most popular stopover spot for tourists that visiting Iran. So now let's move on to the first iconic building, the Ali Qapu Palace, as can be seen in this image. This palace building, it projected above the perimeters buildings that surrounding the square. And let's have some background of this Ali Qapu Palace. Now, Ali Qapu Palace is an imperial palace of the Persian emperors, and is located on the west side of the Naghsh-e Jahan Square. Now, is directly, right, opposite this Sheikh Lotfolloh mosque. The site was originally designed as a vast portal entrance for the square. Now, this palace was built during the Safavid dynasty, as I mentioned earlier, and it is a six-story building of height of 48 meters. And the access to the highest floor are by means of spiral staircase. The largest rooms are located on the highest floor, that's in the sixth floor. And the largest room is well known as the music hall, where royal receptions and banquets were held. I will share with you the picture of this music hall later on. Now, let's move on with some of the images. This is a sign right at the entrance of this palace. And this view from the rear of the palace. From the front, it looks like it's wooden, but at the back, it seems like it's completely built of brick. The leading door to the palace building and the ceiling, the dome ceiling above, is well decorated. Although it's not multicolored in nature, but the design is very, very impressive and outstanding. The decoration on the wall and above at the arch area as well. And we found these two paintings on the wall. Fairly interesting. Some of these artworks. And this image is actually at the highest floor, view from outside, from the front view. Look right out at the sixth floor, soffit of the sixth floor, or rather the sixth floor ceiling. It's where the music hall is located. These are some other images that can be found within the building at the ground floor entrance area. And then this is basically the largest room, as I mentioned, which is the music hall. These are some of the images taken within this music hall. Well, looking up from this palace building at the highest floor, you can see these rows of building. It's basically where the store, the bazaar store, are located. Then we move on to another very interesting building. Now, before I touch on further, just to share with you, now, in this musical hall, as you can see earlier in the earlier images, the deep niches are found in the walls. These niches are not only aesthetically beautiful, but also performing acoustic function. If I were to go back, allow me to go back. For example, these are all the niches, right? And painting in the palace where the Reza Abbasi, while next to the musical hall is a balcony, which also I actually mentioned to you just now, some of the images. Now here you will be able to have a panoramic view of the entire square, which I've took some pictures from this point. Now this palace is regarded as the best exhibit of Safavid architectures, and the symbol of Iran, Islamic heritage. So let's move on to the next place of interest. Now, the next place of interest will be the Sheikh Lotfolloh Mosque. So from the image, you can see this again, this iconic building is stood above the rows of shops that surrounding the square. And let's have some basic information of this Sheikh Lotfolloh Mosque, or it's also commonly known as Sheikh Lotfolloh Mosque. It's rather a modern mosque in Iran. It was built during the Shah Abbas the First regime, and it was completed in the year 1602. Although it's considered one of the modernest, newest mosques, it still already have more than 400 years old. Now, this mosque stood at the east side of the Naghsh-e Jahan Square in this Isfahan city. Now, the tilework of this mosque used predominantly three colors, and the eastern browns, the sky blue, and the gold. Later on, I want you to pay attention to the images that I'm going to share with you on these three colors. One of the brown color represent the earth, and the blue color represent the sky. And at the same time, which symbolize the connection of the earth and the sky. And the design of the mosque follows the articulous regulations of geometry and symmetricity. So later on when I share with you the images, you can see that these two elements of geometry and symmetricity is well emphasized and emphasized in all the design, in all the artworks. So this is the entrance view of this mosque. Here you start observing the blue color tiles of this mosque at the entrance area. So we are welcomed by a leading corridor, a long corridor. And you can see that on the corridor itself, you have see many earthen brown color tileworks. And of course, and with gold as well. As I said earlier, that among so many mosques that we have visited, the tilework in this mosque is very outstanding. Among so many mosques, is considered one of the best. So here you can see all the three colors of tiles and been exhibited, the blue, the browns, as well as the gold. While entering to this main prayer hall with the highest main dome, this is the view internally. The lighting to this prayer room or prayer area of these main domes are from the windows above that at the top of the dome surrounding the domes, as can be seen in all these images. I would rather say that the entire internal surface of this mosques are mostly being finished with tileworks. So here, from here, you can clearly see that the elements of geometry and symmetricity in at all corner of this mosque. For photographer, I would like a wide set because they did not allow flash to be used. Of course, you're allowed to take picture in the mosque, and therefore, I think the use of the fast lens, or rather the lens which can able to open up very large aperture, is highly recommended due to low light conditions. Or rather, you may need to achieve boost up your ISO while taking images in this beautiful, fascinating mosque. The tileworks at the dome ceiling is very, very fascinating and very beautiful. You will notice that they place a lot of brown color tiles at the lower portion while the blue tiles at the higher section. As I mentioned just now, the brown represent the earth as well as the blue represent the sky. This mosque has a large prayers area that's surrounding the main dome, as can be seen in these images. Beside this mosque, there's a large courtyard. As a visit was in the March during the Iranian New Year season, so it's considered the early spring. So you still found that most of the trees are leafless and quite cooling. It's the best time to travel Iran because Iran is have most of the land in Iran fall under desert zone. So therefore, during summer, it's extremely hot and dry. And of course, in this mosque, they have an underground prayer area or chamber, as can be seen in this image. During the hot summer, that the also the cold winter, the prayers was done in these underground chambers. So we have seen this most modern mosque. Let's come visit another very interesting mosque. It's called the Shah Mosque, although they have been given different names. Now the Shah Mosque is located at the south side of this Naghsh-e Jahan Square. It's built in the early 17th century during the Safavid era as well. That's after the Iran Revolution in 1979. This mosque is then renamed to Iman Mosque. That's why I say that this mosque have quite a number of different names that took place in different era. Now, the popularity of this mosque is a 7-color mosaic tileworks and the calligraphy inscription. So I'm going to share with you the images now, please pay attention on both the mosaic tileworks as well as these inscriptions on the wall of this mosque. So from externally, they have two huge tall minarets, fully tiled, and this is basically also one of the key attractions of this mosque. So take note of this Islamic style of this architecture style in this part of the mosque. I like to highlight that because that the Islamic influence will start during the Safavid era after the end of Persian Empire, and this Islamic style of architectures were well merged with the Iranian traditional Persian architecture style. So it give rise to a Shah Islamic culture as well as Shah Islamic architecture style, very, very unique in this part of the world. This is actually the entrance, the main entrance to the Shah Mosque. And right above it, at the niche area, this is the soffit of the niche area. It's well decorated with 3D tileworks. Inside the square, the big courtyard, right at the center is where a fountain, and right below it is actually is where the water chamber. Again, this is actually a very large mosque, and it's the fire prayers was held in this mosque at every Friday. So you notice that all the external facades of this building, the surrounding the courtyards in this mosque, are with well decorated seven colors mosaic tile works. And the entire mosque was built over a period of close to 400 years. During the long era, long periods, there have been gone through many different era of ruling by different people. So there are many extensions adding on to this mosque. So you can see that in this mosque itself, that the design and the architecture built up is not entirely the same. At four corners, you can see four different tile work done at different era. These are some of the items or architects works that found in this mosque: the marble base, and in these sections of the mosque where is the high domes, the entire mosque was built of brickworks with intricate brickworks displays. And I believe this is the oldest section of the mosque. Image taken using a fisheye lens of the dome. It's very dim inside this mosque. The lighting of the mosque entirely rely on the skylight above the roof, with many, many round domes. The brick columns and arches. So both the floor, the wall, the column, the pillars, the arch, as well as the roof, are all built of brickworks. So I want you to understand that this is one of the best part of the mosque, where you really can see the highly skilled of the bricklayer in completing the entire mosque, entire use of bricks. It's truly a masterpiece of its kind, hard to find in this part in the world, and therefore a visit to this mosque is highly recommended. Look at the patterns of the brickworks exhibited in this roof. The brickworks on the huge pillar that supporting the buildings. The arches. This is one of the very beautiful roof, as well as this one. And this part is actually the only section we found timbers were used. Some of these inscriptions, as I mentioned, calligraphic inscriptions on the wall. As usual, the mosques in Iran, they tend to have underground chamber or prayer chambers, and as I have earlier mentioned, the main purpose is to shy away from the extreme hot and extreme cold temperature during the summer as well as winter. The exterior corridors of the mosque. And this photo is showing the passage leading to the water chambers or the bathroom. So this will cover the end of this travel journey to Isfahan. It's only covered part of it. In the coming weeks, I shall share with you the second half of my tour to this Isfahan city. Now, if you are actually entertained and by my travelogues, I will be much pleased if you could subscribe, like, and share to your friends and family so that they can be like you, right? Touring around the world virtually. I thank you very much for staying until these hours with me, and I hope you are in good health. In the coming weeks, as I have said, that it will be the second part of my journey covering this Isfahan city, and thereafter will be another 4 more episodes. In other words, in this second series of my travel journey to Iran, will cover a total of 6 episodes. So please stay tuned and stay safe until we see each other again in the coming weekend. And bye.